Hello guys, this is Cesar Creates, and welcome back to my channel! And welcome back to the Elm Hill City Zoo! Yeah, we are back to our old zoo after starting a new one, I mean the Desert Adventure Park, but now it is time to focus on our good old Elm Hill City Zoo. So in today's episode we are creating a new building for our zoo, and this new building will be an education center. But before I will start to talk more about this building, let me just address one amazing thing. We have hit 1000 subscribers here on the channel. I am honored and grateful for each and every one of you guys. I am amazed by how quickly this channel grows. I uploaded my first video at the end of November, and now by the end of May we have 1000 subscribers. As I already told you before, I didn't even think that I will enjoy recording those videos as much as I do. I thought that it will be just, you know, one time thing just to check out if I will enjoy it or not. But I actually do enjoy it a lot, mainly because of an amazing feedback from you guys. So thank you for all the support, thank you for all the good and kind words. Thank you for being there, watching all of my videos, it really really means a lot to me. I feel like this is like a first milestone for our channel, and there are so many more milestones to come in the future. I actually have a small celebration planned for next week. In my new video that I will upload next week, we'll talk more about this amazing thing, which is 1000 subscribers. And also, I prepared something special for you guys to say thank you. So definitely stay tuned and don't miss it, because some of you may actually enjoy this, what I have prepared for you. This video will be probably out on Wednesday or on Saturday, and you don't want to miss it, so definitely look forward to my new video. Okay, I'm not telling you guys anything more, just go and watch my next video. Okay, so today, as I told you guys at the beginning of this video, we are building an education center for the Elm Hill City Zoo. An education center is something that I wanted to build for the zoo from the very beginning, because I think that they are super important for the zoos. Because zoo isn't only an entertainment for the guests, but it also has this educational part to it that is really really important. Zoos educate their guests about conservation issues of animals. They increase the awareness of people that are maybe not so interested about animals and their issues. Like, for example, destruction of their natural habitat, poaching, and so on. They also many times show the guests what they can do themselves to help animals and to help our planet. So yeah, I think that places like this in the zoos are very important. I went through some zoos online. I mean, I wanted to see how many of them have places like this, and actually a lot of them have them. Maybe not as, you know, modern and complex like we are building today here for our Elm Hill City Zoo, but they definitely have, for example, some classrooms or lecture halls where they, you know, organize some lectures about animals for young people, about the you know, conservation issues from animals. So yeah, I think that it is very very vital for zoos to do. And I actually remember when I was in primary school and we had a trip, a school trip to our local zoo. We visited like a center like this, where there were a lot of posters about the issues of animals, and also we were invited to this classroom where we had this little lecture Of course, it was like more for kids back then, so it was very like entertaining and pleasant. They showed some of smaller animals in there, and this lovely lady tried to, you know, teach the kids something about the issues of animals on the world. But I'm sure that they also do it for students and for adults as well. This building is inspired by something that my Pinterest like recommended to me, because I look for inspirations for my buildings mainly on Pinterest, and I also recommend it to you guys if you are looking for some inspiration for your builds. It's like a mine of inspiration, so you can always find something for yourself. This build is actually inspired by the theater that is located in Chicago. It won several like architectural awards from what I've read, so it is good, you know, to be inspired by those very good pieces of architecture. It is of course not like a recreation. I was only inspired by this thing that I am actually building right now, this wooden part of it. It's just something that I really liked and what I wanted to add to this place in our zoo, because I think that it actually fits the buildings next to it. Of course, I will put the link down in the description to this building if you want to see what I was inspired by. Yeah, I was actually looking quite a lot for inspiration of a building that I wanted to build in here, because the main issue was actually a space where I was building. It was very limited. I think that I didn't like think it through. You know, when I started to build this main plaza, I knew that I want to have three buildings in there. We have a gift shop, we have a restaurant, and some sort of info center or education center. But when I was building those two buildings on here on my videos, on my channel, I actually thought that, okay, I already have three videos with only buildings. It was an entrance, a gift shop, and a restaurant. And I need to start building some habitats, because it's, okay, it's a zoo game, not a, you know, architectural sim or anything like that. So I decided to finally add a habitat, which was a gray seal habitat. And because of that, I left this area like empty, and I decided to go back to it in the future. And now, when the future has actually came to me and it is time to build something in there, I like thought that I could like make this plaza a bit bigger and you know, make those paths a bit also in different directions, so I had more space for this building. But it was too late, and I didn't want to like destroy everything, you know, move everything. Maybe it would be doable, but I decided not to and squeeze this building somehow in this part of the zoo. And actually, in the end, I am very glad with the result, because I think that it suits this this part of the zoo. It suits the buildings that we already have, and it also isn't like a large building out of the scale. It is like a moderate like size building that, you know, a lot of guests can enter. And we have this one lecture hall that you'll see, and I think that it is actually enough for this building. I see comments all the time that some of you guys are not too good at building at this game. I mean building actual buildings, not habitats, that all of your buildings are square or very simple. I had many comments like this when I posted my last build, I mean the entrance to the desert adventure park on the Planet Zoo community page on Facebook. And yeah, many people commented that they are still on the stage of building, you know, square buildings, and I could come up with something like my entrance. It was actually very, very nice, but I think that, you know, watching videos on YouTube, just as this one, and videos by other creators who create also buildings, not only habitats, you can learn so many things from watching those videos. I did myself too. So yeah, if you are struggling, I hope that this video will help you a bit. To get some inspiration from the outside part of the building, or maybe for the interior, because we'll have some detailed interior in here as well. But overall, I think that watching videos on YouTube, trying to recreate some buildings that exist in real life in the game, and also just practicing, those are the things that help you the most to get to know the pieces in game and to figure out how you can turn them into a very interesting buildings, because using some of those pieces in, like, you know, unconventional way is something that actually makes your builds more interesting and more unique. And sometimes you can, like, create such a realistic buildings without using the default, you know, wall pieces from the game, just by creating the walls and the wall decorations by yourself. But yeah, it definitely comes with time, and I think that YouTube helps a lot. A really fun and nice addition to this, you know, architectural wooden structure on this building was adding the lights inside of it, because when you turn the time of the day to nighttime, it actually looks very, very cool. Just as, you know, they add those LED strips to the buildings to highlight something, it looks really, really good with those, you know, different angles of those small wooden pieces in there. There will be some cinematics of the buildings, of this building in the nighttime. So if you want to see it, definitely stay till the end of this video, because it looks really, really cool. In this build, just as in our previous builds with those buildings and interiors, I will use some of the blueprints from the workshop. I use them because I think that some of those builds are really, really impressive, and I love to showcase them here on my channel. But also, creating those interiors is a bit time consuming, because they're sort of detailing. So just to make it a bit, you know, quicker, just to make those videos a bit shorter, I sometimes prefer to use a blueprint, for example, of a bookshelf or a custom computer, just to make things, you know, faster. But yeah, all the blueprints are always listed down in the description. So if you like some blueprint that I use in this video, you can always go and find it on the list and download it for yourself from the workshop. Also, if you have created some blueprints that you think will fit to my zoos and you want me to use them in my videos, you can always send me the links on my Discord server. The link to my Discord is down below in the description. And if a certain blueprint that you will send will be useful for me or will fit my zoo or the build that I'm actually building. I will definitely showcase it in one of my videos, and I will also add a link in the description so other players can download it for themselves. So if you're interested in that, definitely visit my Discord and send me some links. Right now, as you can see, I am creating my custom tiles or floor tiles. I really liked it, what we did for the desert adventure park, I mean the entrance, when we also used a lot of tiles in there, and I wanted to use them as well in here, but I decided to use them on the floor because I'm a bit tired of using, you know, plaster pieces on the floor because they look very plain. So I decided to do something different and to add those tiles, and I love how it looks. Of course, because of it, we have a lot of pieces in this build, and am I afraid that it will like make our game lag a bit and make it slower because of the you know, piece counts? Yeah, maybe, but will I do something about it? No, not at all, because I prefer it to look really good for you guys and lag a bit than using, you know, just paths or some other plain pieces. I think that the look of the zoo is actually more important than the performance, but I may regret my words in the future. Right now, I started to create this counter. This will actually be something very, very cool. It will be an adoption counter. Many, many zoos have something like an adoption program for animals. It is something that you can actually go there and adopt a certain animal in the zoo. An adoption doesn't mean that you can like adopt an animal and take it to your home. It just means that you donate a certain amount of money every month to an animal, and this money covers the expenses of food, of you know, medicine, enrichment for animals, and so on. And it really helps the zoo out because, as you can probably imagine, the zoos have so many expenses just to provide food and, you know, veterinary care for all the animals that they have. But normally you also get a lot of benefits of adopting an animal in zoo. You get, for example, some amount of free visits to the zoo. Sometimes you will get a plate like next to the habitat of a certain animal that you are a sponsor of this animal. For example, a company can also adopt an animal, and it's like a free advertisement for them. It is actually very common in my local zoo that, you know, local companies, they adopt those animals and sponsor them, and because of them they get this you know, advertisement, their logo next to this habitat, and there's also a description that, for example, this bear is sponsored by this and this company. But yeah, you also get some other benefits, like for example a voucher just to use in a gift shop, or sometimes you can even visit the animal. I mean, with a keeper you can go behind the scenes a bit, so it is really cool, and it is a very, very good thing to do for the animals in the zoo. So if you ever considered adopting an animal in the zoo, definitely do go and do so, because I think that it is really worth it. Actually, I am considering, if this channel grows more, I think that I will consider adopting an animal from my local zoo as Caesar Creates, as my channel. Yeah, this is something that came to my mind recently, and something that I will probably do in the future. I just need to do some research about it and how much it costs, And who knows, maybe we'll adopt an animal here as a channel and have it as like a mascot of our channel. I don't know. Yeah, I just think that it would be super cool to do. You could see me do this like trick. If you want to your staff members to just stand in one place and don't move, so you can just pretend that they're behind this counter and are working there, but actually they just stand there and do nothing. If you want to do it, you just need to put one piece of path, 4 meter path. Don't connect this path to anything else. You can hide this path like below something, just as I did here with those tiles, and then you have to move your staff member in there, and he won't be able to, you know, move from this place. To make sure that he faces in the right direction, you need to like put him somewhere in the zoo and let him turn around to the direction that you want, and then right away move him or her, and they will stay in this certain position and won't, you know, turn around when they are moved to this one piece of path. You could also see me creating this exhibition for posters. I came up with an idea that this exhibition of educational posters will be perfect for this building, as there will be a lot of information about the issues of animals and our environment, and it will be all in one place. So I created those stands for the posters that will be there. There are actually 24 of those posters on those stands, and for each and every I did my own design, my own custom billboard. It was a lot of work, but I thought it will be worth it to do it, because I will also have those posters to use in my future zoos, so it was actually something that I wanted to do anyway. So all of those billboards are created in canva.com. It is a really, really useful site for them, so if you are looking for, you know, a place where you can create your own custom billboards, I definitely recommend Canva. I will also, as always, upload those custom billboards to my Discord server, so if you want to use some of them, they'll be available to download from my Discord. You of course will be able to see them all in the cinematics by the end of this video, so definitely stay till the end. Yeah, I created posters about climate change, about poaching, about traditional medicine, deforestation, about classification of endangered species, also about using animals for fashion, and some of them are about the adoption program here at our zoo. So yeah, if you want to see them all, definitely stay till the end. As you can see, I already started to work on this lecture hall. I created my own custom chairs and tables for the listeners of the lecture. I will also do some blackboard in here, some stand for the educator. There'll be some bookshelves that I actually got from the workshop. And yeah, I really like how this classroom or lecture hall has turned out. I have also put an educator there, just as I did with those staff members that are standing there behind this counter. So he or she, I don't remember, will also stand there like forever. As long as you play in sandbox and you have like those settings turned on that the staff workers are always happy, it won't be any problem. He'll just stand there and be happy all the time. I mean, I cannot see any problem. You just stand there, you are happy, and you earn money for this. So yeah, that sounds like a perfect job. So after we'll be done with this classroom, we'll like put some finishing touches to this building. I mean, some decorations, some plants. I will also add doors, like normal opening doors for this lecture hall and sliding doors for this whole building. I also forgot to mention that I added those like screens above the entrance to the classroom. And on those screens, I actually created like a slideshow of some of the, you know, photos from our zoo of the animals. Those are mainly the thumbnails of our videos. I mean, without all the, you know, descriptions and so on. And I think that it is really cool because, you know, it shows our zoo, the history of our zoo, the animals that you can actually see there. So it is also really cool that we can upload, you know, videos to those custom billboards, not only like posters. So yeah, I could even potentially upload my own YouTube videos in there, but obviously I won't do it. But I think that this slideshow is really something very cool. At the end of the video, I will also add some ventilation system on the roof of this building. I found this one on the workshop and I think that it looks so cool. This is one of the reasons why I love workshops so much, because you can learn so much from those things. I wouldn't even think about, you know, using those things to create those vents and so on for this ventilation system. And thanks to this, this building looks much more realistic, because you simply have those things on roofs, even though you cannot see them from the, you know, pavement perspective, but they are there on the roofs. They are crucial for buildings to function, because you cannot build a building without ventilation or some other, you know, air exchange system. So yeah, I really like how it is looking on this roof, and of course you will also find it in the description to this video. Okay guys, this is all that I have for you today. Please enjoy the rest of this video and stay till the end, because there'll be some cinematic shots where you'll be able to see all the custom billboards and also this building during the nighttime. Thank you again for 1000 subscribers. I still cannot believe it. I'm super grateful. And don't forget that in the next episode we'll have something special to celebrate that. Please give this video a big thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Please ring the bell if you want to be notified every time I upload a new video. Comment down below if you liked my video or if you have any recommendations on how I can improve my future videos. And of course, subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and if you want to see me build more of those buildings and realistic zoo habitats. Thank you guys for watching, have a wonderful day, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye guys!
Bye.